So welcome to another video, and today we're going to continue with learning all about the Amazon suspension. What is the mail which has been received by you? What exactly to find out from that mail, how to read that mail, and how finally create your plan of action. So today I'm picking up a case wherein the seller has been slapped with a listing deactivation by the reason sold used as new. That means it is mostly based upon the customer's complaint. It is something which is customer induced and the customer triggered, wherein the customer has got the product, he approached Amazon and shared his disappointment with the product, wanted a replacement, wanted a refund, and shared some pictures with Amazon claiming that whatever product I have received is a used product and not a new product. So I'm going to open that particular mail for which I created a POA, you know, some days back. So I'm going to open up that particular mail. We'll let you know the exact, you know, the terminology which are appearing in that particular email, how to take action on this case. So in case you have slapped with a listing deactivation with the reason as sold used as new, so this is very important for you. So now I'm on that particular mail which I've got from the seller for which I created a POA. So if you read this, it says we removed some of your listings because of customer complaints about the items listed at end of this mail. Of course, what is the ASN number is given at the end of the email. Customer may be complaining because the item they received did not accurately match the condition or description of the product. Somehow you have written in the description that this will come in a 2-ply corrugated box, or this will come with a hologram sticker. So that is something which is not exactly matching up with the description that also tagged in the same category. Or probably the description you're mentioning that, okay, it's a new product and you've sold a refurbished product. So of course, this is also a violation. So now understand what Amazon wants you to do. It says product listed in new condition are expected to arrive in brand new unopened condition with no signs of damage or wear. The maximum problem in this category is hair. You don't ship it properly. Your shipping, when your product gets shipped from your location is perfectly fine, but the time it reaches to the customer, because of the shipping wear and tear, some scratches come onto the product, maybe minor damages happen to the product, and customer has this category only to select that this is something sold product has been seen. When the customer is buying from you, it's not going offline and it is coming online and buying from you, he also expects to have a complete brand new product. You know, he just opened the pack and he gets a brand new product. That's your responsibility to ensure that everything is okay. So now you understand that there has some problem, and most of the cases you will not even get to know on which particular order this problem has happened. So do not rush to Amazon and say which order, which customer. No, it's a feedback which has got from Amazon. Amazon is not going to share the customer details with you. You need to figure it out on your own, which complaints have been received, which refunds have been processed, and so on and so forth. But in this particular case, you need to send a complete plan of action which comprise of these three elements to it. Let's move a bit down here. A plan of action, it is asking for a plan of action which is a written persuasive document. Please remember, plan of action is not a template. Plan of action is not something which you can find it from Google and put your store name and boom, it is there. No, plan of action is based especially it's based on every seller's case. Every seller is unique, every seller's problem is unique, so every plan of action is also unique. So never use any copy paste replies. If you are using a third party service, please understand that it should say what exact the problem is. Most of the third party which I have seen personally, they use cut copy paste templates. They just put in whatever is on the standard template, whether it's applicable to you or not. I was reading a POA. The seller has not sold a single unit of the product. He's mentioned that we have sold 400 units of the product. I don't know, because it was some numbers which are there maybe on old template. So please understand this thing, that be very, very selective. Before you send a draft to Amazon, please double check the entire things. So plan of action that includes the issue that led to the complaint about product condition, description of your items, actions you have taken to resolve this issue, and steps you have taken to prevent future. So these three particular items they want you to make, that's a standard template. Few things here to consider as you create your plan. Now, when they are saying this thing, doesn't mean that you have to see everything. See, they are giving you suggestions that it might be because you are sourcing from a supplier which is giving you old product. That could be one reason to it. Your listing description may not be accurate. Your packaging is improper. Your shipping service is not reliable. You're not able to, you know, understand the reviews and communication which is going on with your customers. So it is not that you have to answer on each and everything. No, in your case, it might be sourcing a problem or listing a problem or packaging a problem or shipping a problem. Pick only the one which is relevant to your case, not everything. You see a lot of POAs. When a POA is drafted, they mention everything. Sourcing, we are sourcing from genuine supplier. This supplier is there. This supplier is that. Listing, we have listed. We have taken so many agencies' help. Packaging, we are packaging and double this, double that, and all that stuff. Shipping, we are using FBA and blah, blah, blah. It does not work. You have to be very, very specific. Plan of action is something which should not exceed beyond 1 to 1.5 pages. That's about it. So you need to be very, very cautious and careful what exactly you are going to draft in that particular plan of action. So whatever the problem is, if the problem is in your shipping, then just focus on shipping and make your root cause. If your problem is packaging, focus on packaging, make your root cause and take corrective actions. Copies of invoices and receipts, yes, you need to provide, and it should be the last 365 days. So today, if we are sitting on April 20, you go back to March 19. March 19 invoice is redundant for Amazon. Amazon considers that if you're not able to sell an inventory, if you're not able to move inventory in 365 days, this product is not even worth to be listed on the marketplace. So that's why they ask for 365 days of agents. Then please include contact number of supplier. Of course, yes, you need to pick up that information, give it to them, give all the information, relevant information of your supplier. And you may remove pricing information. I simply say don't remove that, because don't fiddle it with the invoice part of it. Whatever it is, just send it to them. They anyways have more access on the pricings than you. Okay. So this is the way you need to address the particular case, which is like sold, used as new. So this is the kind of email you will receive. This is how you have to read your email, and this is how you have to create your plan of action. Now, if you think that this series is worthwhile for you, please like this video, please share this video, subscribe this channel. If you want my help in creating a POA, I have put in a description link below in this particular video, below this video. There's a link which is leading to my Facebook Messenger. Just type POA and I will be, you know, get connected with you. If you want to learn how to make a plan of action by yourself, the video is above. Just, you know, click on the above link here. You will be able to create on your own. It's a 32 minutes tutorial, which I've created for sellers, Amazon, across worldwide, wherever you are, in whatever market you're operating in. That plan of action, you can simply take that learning and make it for yourself. And wherever part of India or abroad, anywhere, any marketplace you're watching this video and you're an Amazon seller, UK, USA, whatever, if you want me to generate a POA for you, just follow the same process, connect with me, and I'll be more than happy to help you getting your account back. So I hope you learned from this particular video. Let me just stop sharing my screen. Yeah, so I hope you have learned in detail about this particular case where you get sold, used as new, what needs to be done, what needs to be read, what needs to be picked up. Be very, very careful. Amazon is a template-based organization. They send you replies using their own standard templates. So you need to find which part of the template is relevant to your case. So every word in the template may not be relevant to you, but there are some parts of the template or the replies as a template which are only and only specifically for you. You have to find out those words. So if it is writing sourcing, listing, packaging, it's not all. It is, they're just giving you suggestions. It could be one of them or two of them out of the whole lot. So So just figure it out, the exact reason why the thing is not in place, and take action. Thank you very much. I'll meet you in the next video with another type of suspension complaint for Amazon sellers. Bye-bye. Thank you. God bless.